are you equipped and ready for online recruiting, right? And so there's a couple areas here that I think we need to identify that are important. First one is recruiting tools, okay, that are absolutely necessary in order to help you, again, save time, money. Those are the two most important things, frustration, headaches, whatever it is. Recruiting something that, you know, you're only going to do one time. So you need to have a software, you need to have the tools to help you do that. And, right. You know, having coaches' contact information, you know, finding colleges that offer your sport, you know, knowing that stuff and tracking activity, those are the three things. So let's talk about them a little bit more. You know, coaches' contact information. We know that there's two ways to do it. You can use a database site, whether it's through a platform or, you know, acquiring a database somehow, you can get the information. That's the easiest, most simple way, but you have to be careful too, because there are a handful of companies probably out there that have up-to-date college coaches' information. Like, right. You know, what, you and I have discussed this many times, and part of our team, I make sure that our team is on top of it. We have somebody that manages the coach's data base, right. Make sure it's current, and having all the coaches inside that database so that our athletes can quickly contact those coaches. And we have a system in place if there's any, you know, situation where a coach leaves or whatever, that we can get an alert and quickly fix those issues. So there's, you got to make sure you're getting data from not an outdated site, company or person, people that are right now working and constantly updating data, right?
Right.
The other way to do it is going on the school websites, you know, and then searching for it. And that's a headache, because most people don't realize, but there's a lot of times when you go on these school websites and you can click the sport and they might have a coaches section, they might not. If they do, they might not always give you the coach's email and phone number, so you have to find ways to do it. Now, how do you do that? I'll give the insider tip. You click inside athletics and then you find the athletic directory, but then you got to search it. That takes time. It's not efficient. And the technologies that are out there now, the softwares that are used are right. So affordable. It's a no-brainer.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, with these platforms, I mean, you can filter, right? So let's just say, you know, you want to go to school in a specific state, California, let's say, and you're trying to look for your specific major, which sport you play and which schools offer all this. You can just filter it. It's 3 or 4 clicks, hit filter, and boom, it's going to pop up exactly which schools, right? You're trying to find the right fit school. I always, you know, repeat myself with that, but finding the right fit school is the most important. So you don't want to waste your time looking at these schools that, you know, you might be interested in, big names, but they don't even have the major that, you know, you want to get yourself into.
Finding colleges, you're saying, is obviously, finding colleges is much easier when you have a database of colleges. And to me, the missing factor in like College Board and Niche and some of these other great websites that give you good college information is they're missing that. What does it offer your sport, and what division are they, and the coaches' information and all that. Which, of course, on recruiting sites that have the software built in, you get that information. And as you said, you not only want to know do they have your sport and what division, you also want to know major and location and costs and all those other details, right?
Right, exactly.
The other thing that I think is, it's the most important aspect of recruiting tools, in my opinion, and I believe that everyone would agree, is you want to know where you belong from the people that are recruiting you, the coaches. So tracking coach activity, joining a, you know, a software that tracks the profile views, the tools, the profile views, the followers and the searches, is going to show you where you belong and who's interested, because really that's going to dictate where you fit in the market and what your market value is. And again, you can join more than one platform. You know, it's not to say that you join one. In fact, if you have the money and the means and stuff, I would join as many as possible, because the opportunities will come, as you said. Some may, you know, hopefully all the coaches are using all the platforms, but, you know, different ways it's almost like you see something on Facebook and you don't see it on Instagram right away, and then you see it a little bit later, but
right.
You could be using all these platforms, I believe is super important, but tracking that coach activity, because they're going to tell you where you fit.
Yep.
Okay, so let's talk about some other tech tools here, other software. So, you know, it's important, I believe, the other link is the missing link is managing your process. So, you know, not only do you need to have coaches information, a resume, being able to filter out colleges and see coaches activity, but you also need to manage the process, right? So you need to make sure you're on top of it. When it comes to managing the process, you have, it's basically a CRM. So for people out there who don't know what a CRM is, it's a customer resource management system. It allows you to manage the coaches and where you're at with them. So there are tools and softwares out there specifically to recruiting, but there's also ones that are just specific to business, you know, like certain things like HubSpot or Zoho CRM or Salesforce that allow you to manage, you know, your leads. So you can upload some coaches in there and you can, you know, add notes and you can, you know, connect it to your email. So everything goes into one. You can set reminders, or you can use a simple Excel sheet. Really, this is up to the individual, how they want to stay organized. I believe that everybody has their own methods, whether you want to use a software or not. I don't believe it's a necessity. I think you just need to use something, some type of method to manage your process.
Right, yeah. I agree.
So I think that's very, very important. The next set here is you need skills, right? Mm-hmm. You need to be organized. I know you're big on that, John, right?
Yes.
So, John, let me ask you a question. When you receive an email from a college coach or a phone call or a text or any type of thing you need to do, do you wait an hour, 2 hours? You do it right away? How do you do it? How do you stay organized?
I usually do it right away.
You're one of the most organized people I know. So please.
I do it right away. I mean, when I was getting recruited, again, things were a little bit different 20 years ago. You know, we had the dial-up internet.
As far as being organized, though, it might have been different, but you can still, the tactics of being organized is the same, right? Tell us about that.
I do it right away. I do everything right away. So if I got an email, I make sure I log the email. I make sure I respond to the coach. You know, coaches at time take, you know, sometimes longer than others to respond. So I make sure that, you know, I contact them, or I would contact them right away, whether I have interest or not, you know, out of respect. Log it down somewhere, like you said, in an Excel sheet, you know, and get all the information on the school and kind of create my own target school list and kind of have columns, whether interest or not interest, you know, so I can go back to it every single day, and it would help me narrow it down, right? So the last thing you want to do is you're a senior and then, you know, the panic kicks in and you just don't know what school to go to, or you don't know, you know, much about one coach or another, and you're kind of scrambling just to like find that school, then you pick a school, then you end up being just not happy about your decision, right? So this is a big decision you're going to make, especially. So staying organized on, you know, a life decision that you're making, you're going somewhere for 4 years, you know, you might be paying some money if you're not on a full ride. So you're, you know, investing into yourself, or your parents are investing into you, you know, you're going to be successful or want to be successful after college. So there's just so much to it. So you just have to stay organized. And I'm telling you, stay organized and you'll just feel good about your decision once you narrow down your schools. The biggest piece of advice I can also have as far as a skill, which isn't really a skill, but just be yourself. You know, coaches want to know the true you always. So just be yourself, stay relaxed, and you know, you'll find the right fit school.
Okay, that's good advice. I want to ask you one or two more questions about the organization, because I feel like student athletes need more information on how they can be organized. And parents are obviously able to help, right?
Right.
But let's say that you can't respond to somebody right away. I mean, first of all, that shouldn't be an excuse, right? Because again, it's in your hand. So tell me, John, if you're not going to reply back to the coach right away, because you may need to think about it or
right.
come up with some information, or you might not be in a position, you know, you might be doing something else or training. How do you remind yourself to take care of all these tasks?
Well, I mean, you can set reminders on your cell phone, right? I would create a separate email just so I know I'm going just to one location. This is my recruiting email, you know, John at whatever. I just know that coaches will be just responding there. And that way, you know, I have numerous Google accounts, Yahoo, you know, you don't want to get it mixed up, you know, where you have all your personal stuff and other stuff or whatever you've, you know, applied for, whatever the case is. You don't want it mixed up where you're going to actually miss a coach contacting you or delete something or spam or, you know, just again, clutter, you know, stay organized, have one specific email where, you know, a coach is going to contact you and where you're going to be communicating with coaches via email, right?
Yeah.
Set yourself reminders. Sorry?
Said KISS. Keep it simple, stupid. Yeah. Try to.
Yeah. Exactly. So, and just set reminders. I mean, you know, you have a cell phone.
Well, it does
everything for
you. It's all free too. That's the thing. There's a number of free tools. Like, you know, we can give good advice because, you know, in that department, because we use a lot of these tools, right, John? Like how about Todoist? There you go. There's one for all these kids out there. It's free. You can put it on your phone. You have it on your computer. Todoist. We use it religiously.
Set your reminders. It's telling me in 1 minute, we got to cut this show because we got to move on to other things.
That's right. So, but, like, I remember you taught me too. Like, you did the Siri thing. You'd always say, Siri, you know, tell me, you know, a call coach so-and-so at 5 o'clock today. I mean, it's just, you can do so many.
Yeah.
So many ways. Okay. So being competitive, I think that's necessarily a skill set, but like something that you need to have in your repertoire and is being competitive and motivated. And I think that's part of being organized. Like, you know, you get motivated when you don't fall behind, when you're on top of things, you're excited, things are happening all the time, you're doing stuff, you're in the game, you feel good, but also realizing, if you're organized and you're on top of your stuff, you're being competitive and somebody else is taking your spot. Because although coaches may take longer to respond at times, you need to be on top of it. I mean, you're looking for the opportunity. That's the way I see it. Is the coach has a lot of people coming in and often
line up some schools.
Yeah, like line up some schools. Exactly. So depending on the school, again, like you want to be front in the line. You want to be the guy that or a girl that responds back right away and stays engaged to stay in the front of that coach's list and in front of their face all the time. So that's competition in my eyes, is realizing that there's world competition. And because there's online recruiting, everyone can get a hold of anybody at any time. So you got a lot more competition than you think. And that continues to grow day by day.
Right.
Communication. And that's part of what we were talking about, staying organized, but you got to have good communication. You got to be able to, you know, articulate your thoughts well. You learn that. That's a skill set that parents and other people in your corner can help you with. But I believe communication is very important. Again, keeping the coach updated on your recruitment process, on your development, on, you know, getting back to them on time, letting them know where you're at. I think it's better to over communicate than not communicate at all.
Over communicate and be yourself, like I said. It's important.
I don't see any coach getting upset at somebody because they told them, you know, more information than they needed. You know, this is usually the opposite. Okay, the last part of this is the equipment and technology you need, right? So it's like, okay, well, in order to do online recruiting, in order to be efficient, successful at this, what do I need? Well, you mentioned email address and having a personal email address. I truly believe that too. Creating an email address for me, like Tarek at, you know, Tarek, you know, recruiting or just whatever you want to call it, honestly, as long as it's a new email account that you can manage that is specific to your college and recruitment process, that's
your go-to.
Yeah, it just stops. It eliminates getting mixed up with all the other emails you have. Not only does it help you stay organized and you can click on that and just see that information rather than some banner ad or whatever you get and your friends and messages, you can share that email with other people. So it's not, again, not mixed in with your personal stuff. If you need help with or someone needs to access it. Your parents, for example, want to help you out, your coaches, whoever it is. And I think that it just, you know, gives you an opportunity to have a professional, you know, email there, which I think is good. But using Gmail is important, in my opinion. Obviously, people can use whatever they want. But I like Gmail because Gmail will connect to YouTube. Often, most kids are uploading videos to YouTube. Now it's one account. You don't need separate accounts. And then you have Google Docs, which goes to, again, the organization. It goes to then managing the recruiting process. You can use Google Sheets. You can use Google Docs. You can use all the Google Suites that's there. Again, all free. You can use whatever you like. But I believe those are the best tools. You can share those Excel sheets and so on with anybody you like. Again, you can even share it with the coach, any information you have. I believe that that's the easiest, fastest way to get things done.
Right.
I agree. You also need, you know, you need your cell phone. So you need to have a cell phone. And, you know, how many kids have cell phone? Most kids have cell phones. And if you don't have one, if you're able to get one for the recruitment process, I think that's very, very useful. You can do a lot of things on the go. This is some good advice here is, you know, you could be driving to and from practice every day and could take you 30 minutes to get to the training center. Great. That's a great time to sit there while mom and dad drives and shoot out some emails, jump on a call with a coach if they're wanting to do so. There's endless stuff you can do on your phone. Having the phone is critical, and setting yourself up with all the apps, whether it's WhatsApp, Skype, Zoom, just being ready to go, whatever the coaches want. And then having a laptop and access to a laptop or desktop, you know, computer. You need a computer. There are certain things you can't do on the phone when it comes to uploading transcripts or, you know, sending certain docs or filling out certain applications or, you know, sometimes your profiles. You need to have access to that laptop or desktop to do those things.
One big thing too, just, you know, just crossed my mind as well with the cell phone. If you're ever in a situation where, you know, whether you're in match play or playing a game or training, whatever the case is, if, you know, your parents are there with you or a friend, you know, always take footage. Footage is always good, you know, especially with these phones these days, like the iPhone, and, you know, it's incredible. It's almost better than regular cameras. Keep taking footage, because the more footage, the better. You know, coaches always want updated footage of you, and, you know, you can just continue to send those away.
Yeah, no, makes sense. So you look, you know, if you have this equipment, this technology, which is pretty much what everyone's equipped with these days, it makes recruiting so much easier. So, you know, it's not as daunting as people think. You know, it can be simplified. It can be dumbed down. It can be a lot easier.
It was daunting 20 years ago, I can tell you that.
Yeah, for sure. I mean, it was
painful. It was a process.
No, it was painful. It was painful, and it was a process. I think that, you know, sometimes people see the technology and the online as more difficult, because there's so many. Yeah, you're getting a lot more interaction, and there's a lot more people to reply to. So in one way, it's a little bit more difficult, because you might get 20 schools that are hitting you up that you don't want to play for.
But you don't know. Gem in those 20 schools, right? So, I mean, it's, you can't complain that you have hundreds of schools that are trying to get you on their roster.
It's more work, but it's better work, right? Like, it's more opportunity is what it is.
Right.
And so having that, but then having the ability to reply and do the process at your fingertips is great. So I think it's just gotten easier, but everything in life requires work. So without work, it's important. So I'm going to end off on my side with saying, you got to be committed to the recruiting process. And online recruiting is going to be that much easier if you're committed and dedicated to doing it.